arada shay'an an yaqula lahu kun fayakun. My Lord decreed whatsoever he wishes, and all he tells is be. And
I don't want your kids to be literate. You wouldn't send them to us. Rub minds together and to give us a map on how we want to make these kids literate. So that is why we are here. Secondly, before we start, we cannot start without making us go down the memory lane, our humble beginning. Before now, we know how we've been doing things, how we do our things during our time. Now, every day, per second, things change. Things change. And because of who we are as an institution, we are not going to relax unless we touch the sky and never go beyond. Because of this cast of ours, we are always inquisitive, researching to know how best can we serve the community. How best can we serve the community as an institution? And because of that, we stumbled into a methodology that we want to introduce us to. Some of us may be aware of it, and some are yet to know. Why some, we just want to learn, relearn, and unlearn. We want to learn because learning is part of us as human beings, as Muslims. We want to relearn because continuous learning will make us a better we. And then, sometimes, we have to unlearn. What are we unlearning? There are things we must have learned that we have no choice but to unlearn, to run away from it and not embrace other ways. Why? Because of what we get from it, the outcome, the result. It is this case that made the institution to stumble upon this methodology we want to introduce us today, which is jelly phonics. We have many other methodology, but comparing it with what we were used to in our time, during our time, we went through so many things to make us literate. But today, we are embracing a methodology that will fast track whatever it is we want our kids to get, biiznillah. And by so doing, we can beat our chest and stand tall anywhere, especially in Kano, to say we are the pace setters with regards to this methodology. Although many schools have sprung up using this methodology, and we are happy about it because knowledge hidden is just like a cancer. As Muslims, we are supposed to spread knowledge. As teachers, we are supposed to spread knowledge. So when you get something, you know something, you think, let me hide this thing because this makes me make them respect me. You're only deceiving yourself. So we want to say alhamdulillah for being a torchbearer of this methodology, and we are happy that most schools are embracing this method and we are getting results. May Allah reward every one of us in the best manner. Now, this thing we are talking about, the Jolly Phonics Workshop, what is it all about? As the word, jolly, it's a method of learning that takes a playway method. Really, it is jolly because we are dealing with kids. And kids, when you want to teach them, if you want to teach them with the face of a general, there'll be a problem. So we have to make sure, whether you're a male or a female, you become a female, you become a mother, if you want to handle kids, just like a psychiatric doctor must always be like a mad person. Why? Because the people he deals with are like that. It's not, they are not the one, they are, it's not by that they are making, it's just by default. It's the sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So jolly phonics is a playway method of teaching our kids literacy. And why it is unique is that it covers the three main domains of education. The cognitive, the affective, and then the psychomotor. These three things are captured in this methodology. And that is why we see the result we are seeing year in, year out. Now, the real reason why we are here is to show us a way so that we become supportive partners in progress. Because if we don't call you here, you may think that your kids are experiencing some hallucination when they get home because of the things they'll be doing, what they'll be saying, how they'll be doing it. You'll be, what is this? Because that was not how you were taught. And that is why we want you to be here to see how we do the things in the class. So that when you get home, when you see your kids, you won't be surprised. What are you saying? What is happening? Nothing is happening. Learning is taking place. So we want to encourage them, support them, spur them so that the best of them can be gotten. This is why we are here. So you're welcome once again. So we're going to start right away. Now, Iqra Creche Kano welcomes you to our September 2022 Jolly Phonics Workshop. And Jolly Phonics is a methodology that entails 7 cardinal principles. On your paper, the paper with you shows 5. But I just added 2 now. That is also part of the paper, but it's not captured on that third page there. So Jolly Phonics is a methodology that what operates on with 7 principles. Number 1 is the letter sound. Before now, what we know and how we are taught is using the letter names. A for apple, B for baby, C for cashew, and it goes on like that. But now, this methodology makes use of letter sounds. Although, we are not going to run away from letter names. As we progress, we are still going to embrace that concept. But for a start, one of the principles is what? Learning the letter sounds. Because we are going to be dealing majorly with the letter sounds. Because even when we are taught during our time with letter names, what we were actually doing is that we were learning using letter sounds, but the concept then was not conceived. So the first thing is learning the letter sounds, which is the first principle. The second is what? Learning the letter formation. Don't forget, I said that this methodology embraces the 3 domains of education. They are not going to learn, only going to learn how to read, but they are also going to learn a skill, which is what? Handwriting. Sorry to say, some of us, if we write today, if someone sees it, we may get cataract immediately. There are some persons, when they will write, because there used to be a saying that no matter how bad someone's handwriting is, he or she can read his own handwriting. But there are some persons, I can tell you, I have seen it, they cannot read their own handwriting. To tell you how terrible it is. So this methodology also embraces not just literacy, but even handwriting is also captured in this methodology. Thirdly, the third principle is what? Blending. First, we said letter sound. Second, we said what? Letter formation. Third is what? Blending. What is blending? Blending in actuality is what? Means reading. But it is a what? It's a gradual foundational method of reading. That's how you're hearing SAT, PAT. They are reading, but they are doing what? We call it blending in this methodology. The fourth principle is what? Identifying sounds in words. There is no way we will read when we don't get sounds, or if we don't identify sounds in words. It's not possible. So identifying sounds in words is the fourth principle. The fifth is what? It's a tricky word. And that is the bulk of the problem when we have solved the first 3 parts. Because your child may identify letter sounds and their names, but when they are reading, because most of what we read contains tricky words. And what are tricky words? They are words that we cannot blend. You will get to know it when we continue. They are words we cannot what? Blend. As we continue, you get what we are saying. Then the fifth one is, the sixth is what? Diagraphs. We're talking about letter sounds, but among the sounds, we're going to notice, we'll discover that some sounds contain two letters, even three. We have trigraphs, just like that. Then the seventh, which is the last word, alternatives. Alternatives. Your child may be good in sound recognition. Your child may be good in blending. Your child may be good in identifying sounds in words. But when they are reading, they discover that along the line, they start seeing some funny, funny things. And they'll think, ah, what's happening? Is this magic? It's not magic. We call them alternatives. What are alternatives? There are other methods which some late sounds will sound, but what with different writing. So these are called alternatives. When we start attending to them, you will know why they are called alternatives. So these are the seven principles. Okay, after this, we'll now go to the sounds proper, which is the first one, learning the letter sounds. Under Jellyphonics methodology, we have 42 letter sounds. We have 42 letter sounds grouped into seven categories. As you can see with you and on the screen. So we're going to start right away on how we do these things in the classroom and how you should also view and see your kids when they get home so that we don't have a clash of interest or start having some issues and we'll start receiving some calls. Now, okay. Now, if you look at the screen, in the paper with you, you see an image that looks like a snake there. When we engage these kids at the classroom, we would be telling them in a bit to show them the sound. We use pictorial presentations that mimic or denote that thing we want to talk about, either in their spelling. For example, you see a coiled snake there. Coiled snake. A coiled snake. Now, the first sound we're going to treat is the sound, not S. The sound, not S. So, in taking the sound, you can see what we'll be doing is this, when we're taking the kids, we'll be doing some things simultaneously. We'll be giving the kids action, we'll be showing them letter formation, and then there's a rhyme that goes with it, and a storyline. What is storyline? Now, when you want to introduce the kids to, you know, kids love stories. And as teachers, you have to develop, come up with strategies that will catch their attention. But what we need is their attention. If you're teaching a kid, no matter how beautiful you are engaging the kids, and the attention is not there, sorry. It's good as if you don't do anything. So the first thing we'll do is getting their attention. And what do? A storyline is there. We have a snake. You can say that maybe we went out for a pick, a snake is coming by, and the sound, snake hisses. Class, yeah? Now, we want to, there's a snake coming. Let's watch out. Where's the snake? We get attention. That's okay. This sound is, we're not going to what? With the letter formation. Letter formation. Now, look at what I'm going to do. This is the class. So you have to be careful when you're taking the kids. We are always being careful when you're taking the kids. Why? Because when you want to write the normal S, like, you know, if you want to write S, you do like this. Because if you write the normal S, they will see it the opposite way. So you go anti-clockwise. You make a new reaction. So let's go. I'm not hearing you. We have to be snake now. So let's hiss. Now, so that's the letter formation. That is what? The action that goes with the sound. And what's the sound? Now, when we are taking these kids in a class with our whiteboard, although we're going to show them the information on the board using our marker. There's no board here who have done that. So we tell them that this is the water letter sound. So they should be made to know that. So when you get home, you see your kids doing, nothing is happening. He or she is what? Learning. So that sounds what? So from the book they're going to have, you're going to see with them. So while they're learning the sound, you see the formation and how it is. You know, sometimes when we write, the letter formation is very, very important. You don't say because, how do you write the S? It gives you S. You don't know how it works. Some people give us, they write one C like this and then we'll add the next one. It's not proper. When you allow them to continue like that, they're going to have problem with their handwriting. With regards to their formation and the speed as well. So they should be made to know that the proper letter formation should be taught to them and it should be encouraged and what? You should insist that they make it happen. We have kids, some of us, when we're writing letter 8, we write 1-0, we attach the next 0 to it. It's a bad way of forming letter 8. So every letter and numbers have a way of forming them. So they should be encouraged to make sure they start. Not 1C, 2C. In fact, some of us, it depends on how we encourage them. When you start, you are tired, say, okay, come, just do like this, that's all. And then the child registers that, and then it becomes a problem for him. So please, let's encourage them. While we do that in the classroom, we need a support and encouragement from not at the home front. So this is sound, not letter, S. The next one. Now, this is what? Sound, A. 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 And what's the action? Don't forget, we said, what's the action for this sound? Again. Now, this one is A. 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 And what is the reason behind it? Our A being like this? From the storyline, maybe the kids went to a picnic while they were playing, maybe ants. So take notes. They're going to examine us before we leave here. So the first one is what? And the next is what? Ah, 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 ah. Take note of that. Then we want to tell you something. We said in our message that the reason why we want to invite you here is because we want to make you know that we are going to facilitate your kids to start reading at a very early stage and with speed. We just treated two sounds now. And before you know, we'll be what? Blending. And what is that? Alhamdulillah, is a word called as. 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 So from later, second sound, what happens? Blending will start systematically. Systematically what? We're going to start blending. Now, how do we start blending? Now, we've treated later sound, and now we have done. Now, when we bring these two sounds together, ah, ah, and naturally, we're going to have what? A word. I won't say that word now. Why am I not going to say that word? Because even blending has a process. You know what you're saying? Oh, yeah, it is ah. It's not magic. It has a what? A process and a method. And what is that? It's a gradual thing. After I say ah, so it's a gradual thing. So we continue like this, bring these sounds together, and we are making meanings from the words we are going to form, and these words automatically give us what? Words we are going to have as our reading platform. So don't forget. Ah, ah. If you forget any sound here before we leave, the one we've treated, we're going to pay a fine before you leave. Take note of that. Now, so we've treated sounds and ah. The third sound we're going to treat is what? Not T. If you say T, you have brought two sounds already. It's what? And what is the action? As if you are watching a table tennis being played by players, and then you are trying to follow the ball. And then, and you know the sound now? So you be. So that's the sound and the action. Don't forget. Now, what happens when we continue like this? We will start bringing sounds together. We will be progressing in our later, in our blending, and what? Sound combination. Now, before you know, what are we going to have? Let me, I will do this one as an example. Henceforth, I will call one person to start blending for us. Because the piece already started what? Blending. And I'll take the last one there, which, because it has more sound. And what is that? We start. The first sound is what? Let's go. The second sound. And then we have. Why is this action important? When our magicians will be taking care of your kids in the class, I call them magicians because they are wonderful people. They know how to do their things. Now, when will they be engaging your kids in the class? Sometimes they will not even say, this is. The only thing they will do, they just give you the action and then the put out of the kid's mouth on its own, just like that. So our sound and the action are very, they are key. So it goes hand in hand. So why do you do like this? They give you the sound. So we can use our action to spell a word. You can just say, they'll give you, and then we flow. So they're very, very important. The sound and the action, they go hand in hand. Because of time, we are not here to teach you anything. We are here to guide you. So we're not going to take everything you have, the sound, everything there. We're going to just pick from them, select the word, and then we continue. Next. Yeah. Now, this is the sound. Now, why is saying you should go here? We have two sounds here. And don't forget, we are treating one sound each. But here, they are brothers and sisters. We have the caterpillar k, and the kicking k. We have the caterpillar k, and the kicking k. Now, what is the sound? This sound is k, and the action is what? So we have why we are marrying them here is because, don't forget, these sounds, they come interchangeably. Although they are loose, when we are making use of them, we are going to get there as we progress. We may not even treat it here. We are going to engage them in the class. So this is the caterpillar. We call this C, the caterpillar K. Forgive me for saying C. I don't want you to know what I'm saying, talking about. So I don't know what to see now. So that sound there, the first one is what? The caterpillar K. The caterpillar was? And the other sound there, it resembles K, right? So the other sound there is what? The kicking. So the sound is what? Now, we are going to blend. Stop this. Can you stand up? Yeah. Blend the second word for us there. Now, with the action, please. Now. Hello? This. Okay. Now. Okay. Sorry. Okay. Sorry. Now. That one is what? E. Now. Yes, I speak it. Now, go ahead. No, I will leave you. Okay. Now, Is that possible? Take it gradually. Okay, let me do the first one. We have. I want to start again now. Thank you. Let's roll for him, please. Thank you very much. Now, let's go to the next sound. Now, this is what? The sound E. You can see something that looks like egg. That's an egg. You know, our mothers know that very good in the kitchen. The job is in the neck, yeah? They just open. Innocently, they will just pour. We open and then pour it in the frying pan and do the needful. So that sound. This is action. Eh, 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 eh. That's the sound. So, we've done. Okay, I think we've. Let's move on, please. That's a good one. A good one. It seems you like egg very well. Okay, now. Madam, the next one, please. Okay, hold on. Now, no, go back. Now, look at the third word there. We have. Then we have the flying airplane. So you said then we have again. So tent. But as they progress, I will be having what you call consonant clusters. It's a better process. Like that, you just hear, so, and, so you just blend them together. Then the last one, you see the caterpillar k and the chicken k coming together. So, the kiss, okay, no, let me not say anything now. Let me catch someone. Can you try? No, we'll not use you. You have been in our workshop before. Okay, yes, sir, blend the last word. Help us, please. I know if you're coming. Let me just see if you can remember. Now, the last one. Jade. You're not a good magician at all. Let's look for him, please. It's a good one. Thank you very much. Why is everyone calling someone this? You know the kids, they're innocent. You told them that we have caterpillar and the kicking. So they may want to say, you understand? So there's a rule. Whenever the sound is, before the sound, whenever we had a short vowel, the A, E, E, R, U, when it comes in, the kicking and the caterpillar always comes together. Whenever we have a short vowel coming before them. So they must come together. That is the rule. So when you tell them spell pack, because the a is a short vowel, so that sound you won't have, but you are going to see when you are spelling in the class. Maybe when you are testing them. Oh yeah, spell. Let's go pack. Some will give you P A K. Some will give you P A C. Some will give you P A C K. They are all correct from the beginning. So as we progress, you start sieving. So I won't give you this again. Why? Because the rule says when a short vowel is coming before a sound, you bring them two together. So it's not neck, it's what? Neck. Neck. Now. Yes, sir. Okay. There's a question here. He says that he's having. Here, why do I say pronounce one? Now, if you look at our sounds here, you discover that beneath every sound there's a dot there, right? Yes. How many dots do you see here?
One.
So it's telling you that these two are together. And because of our rule that says when a short word comes before a sound, both the caterpillar and the chicken comes together to give you one sound as k. Is that clear? Sir, is that clear? Okay, so is this just n, e? It's not n, e, k, k, neck, k. No, it's what? N, e, k, neck. Okay, now this one is the sound. I remember someone that wanted to join us about 4 or 5 years back during the workshop. He did very well. He was good, but it was during the workshop we asked him to go. Very good guy, very nice, brilliant. But when we got to the workshop, that's when we knew that this person cannot follow us. You know, the Yoruba, I want to tell you, ah, they say, ha. You know, they say, ah. You know, it's true. Look, you can see the Yoruba laughing there. So, the guy is very good. During our workshop, he will say, oh, yeah, let's go. He say, so he has to leave. So now this was the sound. And what is the action? The story is as if someone has been, maybe I'm running for time. So it's what? The sound. Not ha, but what? Because if you say ha, you have added another sound to the. So we have the what? The is what? Let's take note of that. So if you want to blend the first one, we have what? Eh. Mm. Eh. Mm. So it's blending. Eh. Mm. Eh. Mm. Eh. Eh. Rafia, blend the last word there. You just pretend. No action. Now. Where's the action? Okay, that's a you try, but it's not much. You don't just say it's his. Come on, you have that word gradual. It's and don't forget also we have two sounds there, two words coming together, two sounds coming together, giving us one sound. Take note of that. Take note of that. These are consonant clusters. So you have the e not hit, but what it's giving us what. His. I'm going to continue. Go. Okay. Now, this one is the D sound. From the picture, what do you have there? A drum. And that's what we want. We want the class to be what? To be party-like. Because while they are partying, something is what? Happening. So this is what? The d sound. D. If you're a teacher that's eating that morning and you want to show your strength, then you continue. Let's go. D. And the class becomes what? A jamboree. So this is the d sound. The d sound. And the action is what? D. So the first one we have, d. How do you? Help us with the second word. Yeah. Are you a dad? Let's go for him, please. Thank you. Now, go. No time, go. Okay. Aha. Leave here. Now, this is what? This sound is tricky. It's at the middle between two sounds. It's between the ah and the ah. It's not an ah. It's not like up, but what? Like up. So you have to, if you stand like this, you get it wrong. If you stand like this, you get it wrong. You have to be at the middle. And you have to what? Be careful. Not saying what? Ah! Or an up. So what's that? Ah! I see you want to put on what? An umbrella. Ah! 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 Not an ah! Not an up. So the way you open your mouth, tell us what you want to say. You know, most times when we complain in the classes that these kids, they don't know how to spell. If the teacher doesn't know how to what? Pronounce. You make them finally fail and you not fail them. And you don't want to fail them themselves. So you want to say spell chat. Chat. You not say spell chat. They're not giving you chat, you not say them. You don't tell them chat. You said chat and they gave you chat. I remember when I wanted to join this institution. During the interview, the team were interviewing me, and you know, I'm a worried guy by birth and by default. So the way we talk, we do our we mash everything together. So when we started communicating, they said, what's happening? I said, are you from worry? I said, yes, sir. He said, how do you know? He said, don't worry. So it was later I knew why they asked me that question. So those sounds what? The sound. And the action is what? Take your hand and come closer, as if you want to rap. So the first sound is just what? So this is what? The not sun. Not sun, but sun. Not sun, as in S-O-N. And not sun, as in S-A-N, but what? Sun. 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 The third one is what? Okay, we didn't treat this word. It pained me, I left this one. We have many mothers here. Maybe your mom is cooking delicious meal in the kitchen. And you say, from the aroma alone. So that one is what? Mad. Not mud, but what? Mud. In between the and the sounds. You come at the middle, gives you the word. Now. Go. Yeah. Now, this sound, you can see we are having two things there. When it comes here, before we get here, we're going to have a rule. And what is that rule? If you see here, we're having two vowels there, right? We're having two sounds, the A and the E. So what do we say? Are we going to say A, E, or what? So here, there's a rule that says, when two vowels go walking, the first one says its name, meaning the kids will be taught the letter names. What do you get to this word? Stage. The A, B, C, D, E, Zuas, being taught. Now, so when two vowels go walking, the first one says its name. And here we're having two vowels, the A and the A. So what happens when we have them like this coming together? The other one keeps quiet while the first one now says his own name. And what is his name? It's A. A. There's something I forgot to say. If you notice, while we've been treating the sounds, we've been using what? The lowercase. The lowercase is right? Yes. Why? When we are teaching these kids, you know, most of the things we write is a smaller case. The capital comes at some vintage points in our writings. So most of the time, we make the what? The smaller case letters. As they progress, they also be taught what? The uppercase what? Later. So this one, we have two vowels, the A and the E. So when it comes together, what happens? The first one what? Will say its name. And what's the name of the first one there is what? A. So this sounds what? A. And what's the action? A. 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 Why? Because we have two vowels. One will keep shy, the second one will keep mute. The first one will say its own actual name, which is what? Letter A. But the sound is what? A. Name A. Sound A. Now, so if you want to blend, we skip the first letter there. So what is the actual, that's what? The R sound. R. R. Now, and what is the act? It's as if a dog is playing with a rag. You want to drag the rag from the dog. So you are dragging. So the sound comes from there. The rrr, 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 rrr. So we have the r, a, don't forget. If you look, what the question the writer asked the first time, that why are we having two sounds there and then we are saying just one? Because these two sounds go together, and we're only mentioning one sound. That's why you're having what? A dot beneath the two sounds there. The A and the E, giving us the A, you should have a dot. So you have, so it means we're going to have three sounds from that four letter word there. Three sounds. R, A, M. R, A, M. R, A, M. R, A, M. The second one we have what? A. 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 Then we have what? And we have what? There are three. The action looks similar, but the position of the hands are different. One is it's a motionary simulation. One is what? What is what? Your hand comes and meets your what? Your lips. So the second is what? A. A. Then we have what? A. 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 Tail. Next. Okay, hold on. Sorry. Give us the last word there. Blend it for us. If you miss the action, no salary for you this month. Now. Is that sounds? Yes. I'm attacking your action. Something. The last word. Okay, there was a baby. Imagine, what is the woman's ready to go? What? I've seen this in our offer. Ma, are you ready for that? Pastor, without time. Now, the last word. Learn it for us. Now we have, again, then we have, then A, then we have what, then if you look at this, as we progress, I said we are going to have what's called consonant clusters, here we are having, as what, A, snail. Go. Yes, stop. Good. I won't explain anything here. Okay, no, let me just explain. The sound is what? Oh. You see? I said something before this slide. I explained something. I'm not going to explain it again. I want to crush somebody. So, the sound is what? Oh. From the explanation I gave, from sound, the A sound. Use that concept to give us, to blend the first one, Rafia. Yes, sorry. I will pardon you because I've not given you that gag you're saying. It's what? It's good, not gag, good. And the action is what? Good. G. So that's the G sound. Then we have what? Is it ow or o?
Oh?
Again?
Oh.
Good, not ow. We are coming there. There's another word, I think. Now, so give it, so blend it. How's that like? Good, sit down. Thank you. Roll for her, please. Lots of people like you and us, that's why we are here for this workshop. You know, how's that? I want to say people, you say fearful. So it is that fearful we want to correct now. We all have it. In my tribe, we use it. Our sugar is sugar. Every tribe has their own phonological interference. So we want to correct that fearful. And the phone, we want to correct it. So we don't say phone, but what? We don't say people, but people. So, and I also noticed that they say doubt. It's not doubt, but what? Goods. Oh. Then what? Goods. Hold on. Madam, please blend the last one for us. Thank you. Okay, the first sound there is what? I think you're deflecting what? A balloon. You're removing the air, you want to remove air from a balloon. I did not say, I said, take note. Okay, ma? No, I did the last one. I did it. Now, our action, please. So, foam. Okay. At this juncture, I'm going to pause for another pilot to take over the plane. So I'm going to call on Mrs. Adam Amoritala to continue the presentation. A round of applause for her, please.
Assalamu alaikum. Before we move forward, I would like to take this sound again. In Jolly Phonics, we have rules. And the rule says that, in fact, Jolly Phonics is very wide, and they all have rules. In Phonics, when two vowels go working together, the first one say its name. And it's not going to say the letter name. It's going to say letter name, not the letter sound. Like, hear me this sound, please, from the audience. The sound? Anyone? Okay. This is I. We can see that we have two vowels there. So the I, E. So that E is going to keep its mouth shut. So the E will keep its mouth shut. The I is going to use the letter name, not the letter sound now. So we have I. Let's do it together. I. So we have the first one there. The first one say t, 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 I, t, I, t, I. So we have tie. Now, we can see that each word here has dots. Each dot signifies that word is going to be said once. The letters there are going to be pronounced once. Now we have the second one. The second one is lied. Then we have the other one, tied. Now, the fourth one is a bit long. Normally, we break it when teaching our pupils. We first ask, we might block the other one, block it at the middle. We ask them to blend the three. The first one says, mag. Before we now ask them to spell the last one. The other one says, let's just take it together. Pie. We can see that we have now, magpie. Next. Now we have two. We have a picture there, that's a donkey. And most of us, we know how donkey, the sound that comes from a donkey. Like now, the other one we say, we just have to put our hands like this, like the ears of a donkey. We say, e-o. Let's do it together. E-o. Now the first one, there. What's the first sound? The first sound is t, 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 t. And the next one is what? R. So we have t, r, e, tree. Then the next one is what? Let's write this together. What sound is this? K, 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 k. Uh-huh. O, n, con. K, o, come. Then the other one we have like a snake. Then we have E. That's a long E. In phonics, we have what we call short E and a long E. When two E's are together, you normally say E. This is a long. We call it the long E. Because sometimes when giving them dictation, we'll tell you that, right? You hear the children saying, I see, is it long E or short E? When it's like this is the long E. So we have sin. Then now here are signs we don't hear people say fork. What is fork? Feck. It's not feck. We don't have the word feck. It's not feck. How it is written is O. The first sign is then we have O. Oh, then we have k, 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 the kicking k. So this word there is or k, fuck, not fake. Now we have the other one is sound is b, b, b. Let's say you want to be play maybe tennis or baseball. B. So we have b, e, b. The other one is or t, sort. Next. Now, we can see a bit there, just like a buzzing bee. That's the sound. Let's do it together. Again. Like a buzzing bee. So we can see the first one says z-a-p, zap, zap. Then the second one, now, let's not forget the rules that says that when two sounds are close to each other, the sound is pronounced once. Like the second one, we can see that we have two z together, so it's going to be pronounced once. That's a work of the dot under it. So we have the first one, we have b, b, a, z, buzz. Then the second one we have e, 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 e. Let's take it again. E, z, fizz. Then the other one, we have to break it because it's a little bit long. So we have to break it. So now we are going to pronounce the first one. The first one says z, e, g, zig. Then the second one, z, a, g, zag. So we zigzag, zigzag. Next. Yeah, take it back. Yeah, yeah. So here we can see a weightlifter here. The actions goes like this. Just let's assume we have a 50 kg of bag. We are trying to lift it up. You just bend down like this, I see. Let's do it together. That's it. So we see the first one is. Let's take it. Again. So we have sang, not sang. Or it says song. No. Sang, sang. Now, the other one is what? K, k, k. That is our kicking k. K, k, e, king. Then we have a l, l, o, o, o. Oh, sorry. L, l, o, 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 o. Long. Then we have a, the other one, we can see that. The almost the same pronunciation but different spelling. The other one is the same thing as l, a, n, long. Good. The next one. Yeah. This one is as if we are driving a car. So it's a, n, van. We also have vim. Now, who is going to try the last one for us? The last one. Anyone, please? The last one. Who is going to help us with the last one, please?
Point anybody.
I see Nuseba, please. The last one. The last one, please. With the action. Good. Thank you. Now, yeah, move it. Yeah. Okay. Now we can see that we have the sound here is oo oo. We can see that one is thin and the other one is a little bit thicker. So. Both sound, oh no, they are different sound, but the same writing. Okay? So the first one, that is the one there, we say, ooh, let's do it together. Ooh, 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 ooh. Good. Now let's say the first sound there. The first word there says that. Again, let's do it together. Ooh, foot, foot. Then in the second one say, done. Let's not forget. Zoo. We can see that that one is long. The way we pronounce it, zoo. We can see zoo. Now the other one. Look. 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 Then the other one. Soon. Then the other one. Book. 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 Then the other one. Moon. You can see it's long. Were we able to differentiate from the long one and the short one? See, you have some and short, some are long. Good. Yeah. Let's assume we're all given a cup of yogurt. So we are trying to just say, yeah. Let's do it together. We have a cup. We have a yogurt in our palm. Just say, yeah, 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 yeah. Now, see the first one. Say, yeah, yes, yes. Then the second one say, yeah, ak, yak. Then we have a yeah, l. We can see we have two L there, but it's going to be pronounced one. Yeah, l, yell. Then we have a yeah. Elp, yelp, yelp. Next. This one, just as if we are taking and want to take an x-ray. The x-ray might say, kss. Let's do it together. Kss. 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 Good. So, see? B, O, kss. Box. B, O, X, box. Then we have S, E, X, six. Then we have E, X, E, T, exit, exit. Then we have N, X, next. Good. Good. Here we have two letters. Saying one sound. The action is just like most of us has been to the railway station. We normally see when our chain is moving, like just like a moving chain. Let's do like this together. Like a moving chain, like a moving train. So the first one says, again, or. Chops, chops, chops. Then the next one is ch, e, s, chips, chips. Then the other one is b, a, m, ch, bunch. Then we have a ch, a, m, chain. This one, let's do this, everybody. Let's say cook, cook like a mouth. I mean, we all know duck, like a mouth of a duck or a hen, like a duck's mouth. Say cook, agwagwa, cook, 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 cook. Now let's say, you see the first one, say cook, eek, quick, quick. Then we have the cook, eek, quilt, quilt. Then we have like this one, we break it for them because it's a little bit on us there to spell it. Say l e k, liquid. Then the other one is squid, squid. Now this one, the sound is ow. Let's do it together. Ow, 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 ow. Let's imagine we're trying to sew something, or I need to just spring around, just say ow, ow. Here a man say, ouch. No, say ow. Now, the first hand is what? Who is going to help us with the first one? The first one. Who will blame the first one for us? I say our, the first one. The first one. Now? Yes, they are vowels, but this one, the root does not apply to this. The root doesn't apply to this. It's not the, that's why I say, they have, all of them, they all have roots. So they are vowels, but the root doesn't apply to this. So this is why I say, ow, ow. Now, help us with it, with the first word there. The first one is what? K, l, ow, d, cloud, cloud. Then the second one, anyone, who is going to help us with this? Anybody? Good.
And just like the first one, as they progress, that first one, sometimes they progress to and the second one, we have what? Crowd. So they won't separate the and the again. But they progress, they'll be in perfect column clusters, and they just keep them together and we continue.
Okay. Thank you. Now the other one, the third one is, let's do it together. Ow. We don't say mouth. We don't say mouth. No, it's wrong. In like the three-ish, we have the voice and the voiceless. It's mouth. Mouth, not mouth. Open your mouth. No, it's mouth. Mouth. So we have a ow. Mouth, mouth. Then the next one we have, I didn't teach you that one. Those S and H says, shh. Oh, mommy is at home, don't disturb him. Or daddy is sleeping, don't disturb him. Let's do it together. Shh, shh. Let's take it now. Shh, ow. Again, shh, ow. Shout, shout. That the next. This one is very, very important. At times, we do hear some teachers or parents telling their kids or children, go and bring the oil for me to cook. Bring the oil for me. Or what is soil? No, there's nothing like what is soil. Or go and bring oil. There's nothing like oil. The sound here is, let's do like this together. All, 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 all. It is, so the S-O-I-S says oil, soil, not soil. There's nothing like soil, it's soil. Then the other one says what? Joint, joint. Then we have p, oint, point. Then we have v, oint, void. Good. Next. Now this one says you. Sometimes here, get me my car key. I'm going to the filling station. I want to go and buy fuel. I'm going to the filling station. There is no fuel in the generator. I don't have fuel in my car. It's not fuel, Lou. It's not fuel. Now here says you. So the first sound there is what? You, l, few. Let's take it again. You, l, few. Not fue, few. Now the second one, we break it. Okay, we can break it. So the second one is what? You. Start. Start. Then the other one is? A-L-U, valley. Then the other one is R-E-S-C-U, rescue, rescue. rescue, not rescue. Rescue. Good. The next one. Not here. We have a mixer. We are trying to bake some things. So we have, let's do our hands together. Air, 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 air. Sometimes we hear people say verb. What is a verb? Or what is a verb? Verb. No. The correct pronunciation is air. The sound there says air. Verb. Verb. We can see the first one says verb. Verb. Then we have, we do hear, like in British English, we do hear when they are, whenever they are saying, they want to say like, we normally we say water, but then they will say water because the T there is silence. And when they want to say like something like bearer, the we here will say better. The T is silence. And when they want to say lera, we will say letter. We see that the T there, they are all silent. So now we have a l, e, t. We can see we have two. So it's going to be pronounced once. We have l, e, t, r, letter, letter. Then we have a, let's do that in Kudara. E, m, t, r, winter, winter, not winter, winter, r. Then we have the other one, r. A run, r, a n r, runner, runner. Good. Then the other one. Now, let's assume we are with our dentist, and the dentist asks us to open our mouth. He wants to see something. Say, let's do like this. Ah, 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 ah. Now, the first sound there is. Ah, ja. Then we have a. With second one is there. D, d, a, k, dak. Then we have sh, 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 a, k, shak. Then the last one we have. S. No, I'm not going to do it. He's going to pronounce it for us. The last one. Who will help us with the last one? The last one, please. Who is going to help us? Auntie Asha. Mhm. 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 Scarf. Thank you. Now, we are going to quickly do one or two tests. Now, just look at me. I will give you the action. You give me the word. Okay? I'm going to give you the action. Now, let's go. What is it?
Four.
Now let's take another one. Let's go.
The next one. Thank you very much. We talked about the fundamentals of Jolly Phonics, and we said it has seven principles, and one of them is tricky words. You see our tricky word tree? Now, what are tricky words? A time will come, your kids will come home singing. Tricky words
are words we cannot blend.
And truly, we cannot blend them. Because ordinarily, you've told us that okay, let me use the candidate now. You told us in a class that letter B is B and letter E is E. And you say B E. What will they tell you? B. But these are tricky words because they don't follow the rules of Jolly Phonics. So they are words we cannot blend. They are unblendable words. And we have many of them in our day-to-day interactions and communication. So they need to know these things by heart. It's not magic. There's no rule to it. They just have to learn these words by heart. And as a result of that, when they're telling them these words, these tricky words, we have the tree, we have the flashcards. There are many. This is just the tip of an iceberg. There are many. So as time goes, they take them in groups. So, for example, we have, instead of saying where, we're going to have what? We, W-E, we. It's a tricky word, so they should know it by like that, and by their heart, and in spelling, and in pronunciation. So they don't blend these what? These words. So there are many. We have the da, we have the of, the da, the I, the she, and many of them. There are many. So, and when you get see their books, you see many of them. They treat them in what? In stages. Now, we also talked about diagraphs. We've treated some of them, but these are some of the diagraphs we have. We have many. We even have trigraphs as well. There are many. So these words, what do? They come together. They're made of one sound, but they come together to give you one what? They give you one sound. Although there are many letters, but they give you what? One sound. Two or more letters giving you one sound. The A, the O, the I, and the rest. Now,